milk is consumed by everyone in one form or another, and this became an important reason for it being chosen for large-scale fortification with essential nutrients. Initially, Rajasthan government started milk fortification with support from GAIN and IIHMR University, but is now doing it on its own. To understand the right procedure of milk fortification, let's go to a dairy plant. This is the milk receiving area of the dairy. Here itself, the received milk's appearance, smell, sediments, temperature, etc. is tested. Then, to ensure that the received milk is of proper quality, certain important tests are done in the laboratory. After this, milk is homogenized and standardized as per requirements for toned, double-toned and full fat. Now starts the fortification process. The first step of fortification is to warm the premix between 40 to 45 degrees centigrade. While warming, slowly shake the premix bottle. For 50 metric tons of milk, 1 kilogram of premix has been prescribed. Milk fortified in this way has 770 IU of vitamin A and 550 IU vitamin D per liter. The warmed premix is now mixed with some quantity of milk to prepare a pre-blend. The ratio of premix and milk in the pre-blend should be between 1:50 and 1:100. After thoroughly mixing the pre-blend, add it to the milk. After the pre-blend has been properly mixed with the milk, pasteurization of milk is started. Then the fortified milk is cooled to 4 degrees centigrade. This is the time to test the fortification of milk. Regularly, a sample is taken from each batch of fortified milk to test vitamin A in the milk. After properly mixing the milk, a sample of 200 ml should be taken in a beaker or open-mouthed bottle covered with paper or aluminium foil on all sides. This sample should be sent to the laboratory immediately for testing. There may be a requirement of testing the sample later on, so it should be kept at a temperature of 0 to 5 degrees centigrade. Key points to remember related to the sampling of milk. The equipment used for sample collection should be clean and dry. Samples should be tested the same day. The cap of the sample bottle should be tightly closed and bottles should be kept away from sunlight. Samples should be labeled with their batch number, time and date of sample collection and other important information. Before packaging of fortified milk, the blue color test is done to determine the presence of vitamin A. Take 30 ml of milk in a 50 ml centrifuge tube. Add 10 ml of 2-propanol and shake thoroughly with hand or Votex mixer for 1 minute. Now add 10 ml of N-heptane and a small volume of saturated saline solution and shake it with hand or in a Votex mixer for 1 minute. Centrifuge the tube for 10 minutes at 3000 RPM. After centrifuging, transfer the yellowish organic layer formed on the top into a new test tube using a pasteur pipette. From this test tube, transfer 2 ml of the organic extract to another test tube. Add 0.5 gram fluorosil to it. Now add 3 ml of trifluoroacetic acid solution. The development of a blue color indicates the presence of vitamin A in the milk. For quantitative analysis of vitamin A and D in the milk, a 500 ml sample should be sent to a NABL accredited laboratory. After getting satisfactory reports of all samples, this nutritious fortified milk is ready to be packed and sent to the consumers.
Vitamin A fortification is a very simple and easy process. We can add it during processing or before packing. It's a heat stable vitamin. Losses during processing is very minimum. RCDA, being a cooperative sector, we have some social responsibilities to overcome the deficiency disease of our society.
Last, but not the least, certain important points to remember regarding milk fortification. The Certificate of Analysis, COA, should be checked at the time of receiving the premix. The batch number, date of manufacturing, and expiry date should be checked on the premix bottle. The vitamins in the premix are light and heat sensitive. Therefore, store the premix away from sunlight and other chemicals in a dry and dark place at 20 to 25 degrees centigrade. To avoid a shortage of premix during the production process, the operator should get adequate stock issued as per the batch requirement. The premix should be issued on first in, first out FIFO policy. Stock register should be maintained by making proper entry of receiving and issuing of premix. Sufficient premix stock of at least 3 months should be maintained to ensure smooth supply during the fortification process. Daily record of the consumption of premix and quantity of fortified milk produced should be kept. The quality of water used in the dairy should also be checked regularly. For all information related to milk fortification, please visit www.foodfortificationrajasthan.in. By taking care of all these points, we can be sure that this milk fortified with vitamin A and vitamin D will not only keep us healthy and fit, but will also keep our bones strong.